They are two R letter method. More or less like the one we had, the wave resistor method. You can choose either diagram. E.g., if we took a 4-bit digital to analog converter, so it's more or less like the other one, but with now resistors on top, so they make up like a ladder or a ladder. So I have the 2R and R. That's why they call it R2R. And I have the 2R here. I have an R here. 2R.
So
if we suppose that all the switches are in position one, suppose all the switches are in position one, then the equivalent circuit,
and then we ended up with, that's how we ended up with this subject. after we have put it on one.
Hence, our IVF will be the same as VF over R. And for anybody who came, IK would be equal to IVF over 2 to the 4 minus K, where K is any value between 1 and 3, since it is a 4-bit. IF, that is the feedback current would be V out over RF for this part of the operational amplifier. And we know that for an ideal operational amplifier, we say that when we add all of them, IF plus this I0, I1, I2, I3, that is our summation, K equal to 0 up to 3, IK. IK are these ones here. These are the ones that we are presenting as IKs. So this will be the same as 0. Hence, we will come out with V out being the same as minus RF over R V ref E moon a half plus a quarter plus an eighth plus a 16th. In general, we can generalize the output voltage will be the same as minus feedback resistance over 16R V reference E nu AB3 plus 4B2 plus 2B1 plus E0. That is where E repeats. Where B goes for bits. So these are 8 bits for the third bit, the fourth bit, 4B2 is for the third bit, 2B1 is for the second bit, and B0 is for the first bit. So now when you are, those of you who are majoring in mathematics, when you are teaching this too, you will be telling them when I was, you should be telling them when I was doing digital electronics at Makerere, base 2, we were using base 2 to get bits. For any bits, then V out, these were only 4 bits. This is only, the arrangement we had was only for 4 bits, or 4 bits, R2R lambda resistor method. So this would be the same as full scale range over 2 to the n, E nu, summation I equals 0 up to n minus 1, 2 to the power I, VI. And the full scale range is the same as minus feedback resistor over R, the difference. We note that to get the resolution of this method, the resolution would be the same as delta V equals to FSR over the 2 to the power n.
And the summation I equal to 0 up to n minus 1, 2 to the power I V I is actually a decimal number or number. Now the behavior of the switches, or the way we play around with switches, these are usually FET switches, field effect transistor switches. Form of IC chips, of IC chips. So it is not that you are flipping a switch like this on or off. So you have transistors which are doing the switching, and then they give you the bits if you are converting from. Yes. Zero with a difference of one up to three. So I just don't say 0, 1, 2, 3. It is from 0 up to 3 with a difference of 1, 1, 1. The K are these. We have the resistances arranged and with the currents here I naught, here I one, I two, I three for a 4-bit system which we are looking at. The resistors For the resistors we have ladder made in thin film form on a chip. You've seen, if you have opened the any digital system, even if you open a computer motherboard, you will see as if it has a rush, some black stuff, you know, as if some things were painted. That's what we mean by thin film. Thin films are like the layer you put on this car, windscreens, weapon. That's thin film technology. So you cover either metal or whatever it is with a thin layer in the nanometers. So that's why you hear of the words like nanotechnology. So when you are dealing with thin films, you go up to that scale of a billion in thickness. Now, most practical. Most practical DAC circuits are based on the R2R ladder method. Common methods. Common methods used in their order. In their order of decreasing speed. We have flash or parallel converters to, we have successive approximation,
excessive approximation method, and then three, which will be the slowest, the dual slow method. And I will start with the flash comparers. Let's start with flash combara, so power combara, or let's look at them as being many. These are the fastest because we wrote them in the order of their speed. The input signal is compared at the same time with several subdivisions of reference voltage. So EG, for example, for a 3-bit flash converter, about 2 to the power 3, which is equal to 8 comparators. And then plus 8 subreference voltages, So it means we have about a bunch of 9 resistors to subdivide the reference voltage. So the diagram looks nice. So I will allow me to first feed it to you with 9 resistors. So I have to draw 9 resistors. In order to get the amount of comparators which I use. The comparators are
Basically, like all pumps, 7-1-1 or version of the trials. I don't know whether that makes yes, you're okay. So I will have the reference voltage divided by these 9 resistances. This is my reference voltage, Vref. So I will divide it using this. So this is my potential divider with these many resistors. And then I will have the comparators along this line. So I will draw each of them from here and here. I will get the first comparator. Then from here, and then around here, I get another one. They have to be 8. Here, and here, I get another comparator. Another one. You were laughing at me when I was driving, so sorry for something. Do you find my telling you suffer strain? I'm supposed to tell you to enjoy, but I'm not a sadist. We have this. And finally here, have this, and this one doesn't go this way. Are they 8? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And then this will, all this will fit within what we call priority encoder. So you are used to a decoder, this is an encoder. Then it gets encoded, and then finally you get the bits. So you would have converted from analog to digital. Hence our analog digital converter. The sub-reference voltages, the D1 to D8, DI, equals to 2i minus 1 over 2n plus 1 V reference, where i is equal to 1 V
differences of 1 up to 2 to the power n. This can be written as 2i minus 1, d difference over 16, which is about 0.0625 in 2i minus 1 v ref. The comparators, the comparator is a level detector whose output changes when the input exceeds. Exceeds or falls below. Or falls below a preset value. E.g., if we had our comparator with a VREF. The VREF and VIN plus minus with our VOUT, we would have the graph in this form, but it changes when it is either below. Alright, so we have VCC here, minus VCC, below a given value or above a given value, and this would be our V difference, and this is our V in. So when the input, this is the V out. And, we can have V in then have V ref. The problem will be different, minus plus. It's being the V out. And the graph will look like this. Minus VCC. Plus VCC, VREF, this is V. On Tuesday, I'll be able to summarize. I will go to the encoder, we draw the possible combinations from comparator C naught up to C. We say these comparators C naught, C 1, C 2, C 3, C 4, C 5, C 6, and C 7. Because they start from 0, they stop at C 7, but they are actually 8 comparators. So we shall be able to draw like possible combinations. It's more or less like a truth table, and see how we get the values, how we are able to get these bits here. So we can start from when these comparators are all low, and then see what bit we get. When only comparator 1 is the one which is high, then when comparator 2 is also high, until when they are all high, which value will you get as an output? Y1, Y2, Y3, sorry, Y2, Y1, Y0,
the B2, B1 easily. And then we would be able to move from 0 up to 7 in decimal or in decimal. Okay. See you next week, and then see those on Friday group tomorrow afternoon.